Hi everyone! In this video I'll show you how to configure access permissions in Samba, allowing you to clearly define who can read and who can write to the shared folders. And here's the diagram showing the access permissions we'll configure in this video. First, we'll create separate Samba user accounts, then specify that Samba 1 has read and write access to Share 1, but read-only access to Share 2. Likewise, Samba 2 will have read and write access to Share 2, and read-only access to Share 1. Now, open the terminal window or connect to your Samba server via SSH. First, make sure the Samba service is running on your server. If the status shows active running, that means the Samba service is working properly and you can move on to the next step. Next, we'll create the first user account called Samba 1. This account is used only for accessing Samba shared folders, so we don't need to create a home directory or allow system login. In the same way, we'll create a second user account called Samba 2. Now we'll set Samba passwords for the two user accounts we just created. Enter the password you want to assign to this user. In the same way, create a password for the Samba 2 account. Next, we'll create a new group called Group Samba. This group will make it easier to manage access permissions for Samba users later on. Next, we'll add both Samba 1 and Samba 2 users to the Group Samba group we just created. This allows both accounts to share common access permissions within the Samba configuration. After adding both accounts to the group, check again to make sure that Samba 1 and Samba 2 are actually included in the Group Samba group. If the output shows both Samba 1 and Samba 2 as members, it means they've been successfully added. Next, we'll create the folder structure to store our Samba shared directories. First, create a root directory named Samba. After creating the main directory, next we'll add two subfolders inside it, Share 1 and Share 2. These will be two separate shared folders corresponding to the user accounts we created earlier. Next, we'll assign ownership for each shared folder. The Share 1 directory will be owned by the user Samba 1 and the group Samba. In the same way, for the Share 2 folder, we'll assign ownership to the user Samba 2 and the group Samba. Now, we'll set access permissions for both shared folders. Here, I'll grant read, write, and execute permissions to the owner and group, while allowing read-only access for others. As you can see, the command output shows the list of folders with their access permissions. Now, let's open the SMB configuration file to define the two shared folders we created earlier. Inside Vim, press ESC, then Shift plus G to move to the end of the configuration file. Next, add the sample configuration content I've prepared here at the end of the file. Now, I'll go through each line of the configuration so you can understand what it does. This is the display name of the shared folder on the LAN. You can change it to any name you prefer. This is the actual path to the shared directory on the server. Samba uses this path to locate the files. This allows the folder to appear when users browse the network. If set to No, it will be hidden, but still accessible via direct path. This means the share is not read-only, allowing users to edit or modify files. This enables write access, usually used together with read-only equals no. Only users who belong to the Group Samba group can access this folder. Defines default file permissions. The owner and group can read/write, others can only read. Similar, but for directories, allowing the owner and group to read, write, and access folders. Ensures all files created in this share are owned by the Samba 1 user, making permission management easier. And only the Samba 1 user is allowed to write to this folder. The Samba 2 user can only read the files, not modify or delete them. Similarly, for the Share 2 folder, we'll use almost the same parameters, just with the access rights swapped between the two users. Now, restart the Samba service to apply the changes. After restarting, we should also check the service status to make sure Samba is running properly. As you can see, Samba is now running again without any errors. Finally, let's check the IP address of the Samba server. We'll need this address to connect from the client machine. Now, let's switch to the client machine to test access to the two shared folders we've just configured. On your Windows computer, open the Run window, then enter the IP address of the Samba server to connect. At this point, you'll see the list of shared folders available on the Samba server. Now let's try accessing using the Samba 1 account we created earlier. Try creating and deleting a file in this folder. You'll see that the Samba 1 account has full read and write permissions. Next, let's access the Share 2 folder to check this account's permissions. Now, try creating a file in this folder. You'll notice that the Samba 1 account doesn't have write permission and can only read the contents. And that's it. We've successfully configured Samba with individual user accounts and custom access permissions for each shared folder. Hopefully, this video helps you manage your own file sharing system more easily and securely. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next video.